been faithful, you've been true, and you've done all that you could do. And for your faithfulness, it's your time. You applauded for the rest. Now is your time to be blessed. And for your faithfulness, it's your time. You've been faithful.
You've been true.
And you've done all. For your faithfulness,
and for your faithfulness, it's your time.
You applauded
for the rest.
Now it's your time to be blessed. But you held on, and you were strong. And for your faithfulness, it's your time. You encouraged everyone else when you needed it for yourself. And I want you to know that for your faithfulness, it's your time. You waited and waited.
You have waited
for so long.
For so long.
But you held on.
You held on.
You were strong.
You were strong.
And for your dedicated to all of you who have been working in the vineyard for the Lord for what seems like a lifetime. You have dreamed and you've worked towards things that you've wanted to accomplish for yourself. But somehow your biggest goals always seem to be just out of your reach. But the Lord told me to tell you that He knows who you are. Yes, He's seen your work, and He's also seen your tears. And He wants you to know today that you're not forgotten. He's here to reward you for all your faithfulness. For He said in His word that if you will delight yourself in Him, He will give you the desires of your heart. In other words, not only will He give you what you need, but He promised to give you whatever you want. So don't get discouraged. Don't give up. Hang in there. And prepare yourself for your blessing. It's your time now. You waited and waited. You waited for so long. But you held on. You were strong. And for your faithfulness. Because you hung in there when times got hard.
For your faithfulness.
And when it seemed like nobody cared, you kept out on working. You kept out on doing good things. And for your faithfulness.
For your faithfulness.
For your faithfulness.
And for your faithfulness.
Good morning, my brothers and sisters. We greet you in the precious and anointed name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. I humbly stand before you to say thank you, Pilgrim, for allowing me to serve you for the last 16 years. God has truly blessed us through that time, and I humbly thank him each and every day for this assignment. I thank him for giving us the ability to continue our worship experience even by way of YouTube. Knowing that we have been out of our church for 34 weeks now, but yet God has kept us moving through the technology that we are able to share. So I thank you, and I ask that you continue your prayers for me and my family as I pray for you and yours. Come with us this morning as we journey into the book of Matthew, chapter 16, verses 30 to that of 20. Speaking from the thought, do you know who he is? Oh, I thank God this morning just because I serve a God that I know is real. I serve a God that don't have to move, amen, that I don't have to move, but who can move me? And so I invite you to join us this morning as we go once again into this worship experience. Do you know who he is? And I pray that you have a God-blessed day. Good morning, my brothers and sisters. We greet you once again with Jesus' joy. We are humbly standing before you on this day, knowing that God has blessed us once again to arise from our sleep and to partake of another worship experience. I give praises to God, for he has brought each and every one of us a mighty long way. As we come to you this morning, we come to you from a portion of scripture that we have investigated before, but I come to you this morning in a different mindset, knowing that the Lord, amen, has been gracious to each and every one of us. So as we come to you, we come out of the book of Matthew, chapter 16, the book of Matthew, chapter 16, and I will be reading from the New King James Translation. As we peruse the scriptures, let us hide the word of God in our hearts, that we may not sin against him. Starting at verse 13 of this 16th chapter, when Jesus came into the coast of Caesarea Philippi, he asked his disciples, saying, whom do men say that I, the Son of Man, am? And they said, some say that thou art John the Baptist, some Elias, and others Jeremiah, or one of the prophets. He saith unto them, whom say ye that I am? And Simon Peter answered and said, thou art the Christ, the Son of the living God. And Jesus answered and said unto him, blessed art thou, Simon Bar-Jonah, for flesh and blood hath not revealed it unto thee, but my Father which is in heaven. And I say also unto thee, that thou art Peter, and upon this rock I will build my church, and the gates of hell shall not prevail against it. And I will give unto thee the keys of the kingdom of heaven, and whatsoever thou shalt bind on earth shall be bound in heaven, and whatsoever thou loose on earth shall be loosed in heaven. Then charged he his disciples that they should tell no man that he was Jesus the Christ. My question this morning as we come to you, amen, do you know who he is? Do you know who he is? I come from this portion of scripture that has been laid upon my heart because of the difference of opinions that have come from many who are walking on earth today. There are those who may not even believe that Jesus is the Christ. But Jesus was taking a moment, as he had set aside with his disciples to catechize them as to who he really is. First of all, he wanted to know what was said of him among the common people. No, he did not ask what did the Pharisees say or what did the Sadducees have to say or even what the Zealots had to say, but he wanted to know what the average person had to say. And brothers and sisters, as he came into the coast of Caesarea Philippi, he being apart now with his disciples, took time to ask them the question, who, amen, do men say that I, the Son of Man, am? Normally, you would not ask a question, but I have to ask the question, do you know who he is? I want us to come to an awareness that without the knowledge of Christ and without the relationship of Christ, it is hard to praise God, amen, when you don't know who has given you liberty, freedom, and the forgiveness of sin. As we have journeyed in the ministry, as Jesus was preparing his disciples to be better ministers and better preachers as they were preparing to evangelize the world, knowing that his time on earth was limited. Therefore, he poses this question to his disciples, whom do men say that I, the Son of Man, am? Now, it is by no accident that he uses the term Son of Man. We find this term being used, amen, even in the book of Ezekiel. Ezekiel was known as the Son of Man, but he was called the Son of Man to humble himself unto God and to keep him in line with God. Here Jesus uses the term, amen, because he, amen, had humbled himself to the service of God. Amen. Now, I want us to grab hold of that. Amen. Knowing that Ezekiel was humbled to keep him in line with God. Now, Jesus uses the term because he humbled himself into the service of God. Brothers and sisters, how many of us have humbled ourselves and we are real, amen, with our relationship with God? I come to pose this question because Jesus knew that his disciples had a tedious journey ahead of them. How could they preach the gospel if they had no relationship with the Son? And brothers and sisters, this is where we are at the moment, knowing that there was trials and tribulation during the time Christ was on earth, during the time he was in ministry, performing miracles among them. Now he wanted a man to know what the average person was saying. And here, amen, in the text it says, and they said, some say that thou art John the Baptist. Amen. Knowing that John had already been beheaded and was now, amen, dead and had been placed in the grave, they thought that John had been reincarnated in Jesus, knowing that Herod was so afraid of him that he thought that Jesus was John who had raised from the dead. But John did not do the miracles Jesus had performed. Some say that he was Elias. That was Elijah. Amen. And others say that he was Jeremiah, amen, the weeping prophet, because Jesus was known to weep over the situation of Israel and the people. He even wept, amen, over, amen, Lazarus, when Lazarus was dead and in the grave, knowing that he was going to resurrect Lazarus. But yet he cried because of the lack of understanding and belief of the people. Jesus turns and says unto his disciples, because he wanted them to know and understand, amen, who it was that they would be preaching about. But he says unto them, whom say ye that I am? And this is where we pose the question, do you know him? I want to pose this question, because down through the years, amen, the 36 years that I have been proclaiming the word of God, I have, amen, grown, amen, by grace, amen, in my understanding and relationship with our Lord and Savior Jesus the Christ. The disciples were, amen, living in tedious and turbulent time when Rome, amen, had jurisdiction over Jerusalem. And there were rules and regulations, amen, that were placed upon them from the Pharisees and the Sadducees that was overbearing. Some did not know how they were going to make it from time to time. And when we look back, how can we get through, amen, troublesome times if our faith is not predicated upon God and his Son? Brothers and sisters, the time of the pandemic, amen, has permitted Pastor Rector to get closer to our Lord and Savior Jesus the Christ. It has permitted me to peruse and meditate more over the scriptures, praying, amen, earnestly for the covering of the sheep of Pilgrim and those, amen, around the world. I lift up prayers to those who have lost loved ones to the pandemic. I lift up prayers to those who have been cut down, amen, by violence and anger and bullets in the streets. I take time to lift up, amen, prayers to all of those who may be found out of the ark of safety. He says here, but whom say ye that I am? Brothers and sisters, I want to thank God this morning, because I know who I serve. I don't have to wonder, amen, and I don't have to look around to tell somebody who I serve. I'm glad, amen, to be in the service of my Lord and Savior Jesus the Christ. I heard Simon Peter as he answered the question when others, amen, were silent. This was an inescapable question, because if you're going to practice ministry, if you're going to serve God, amen, with all of your heart, with all of your mind, soul, and strength, you need to know who Jesus is for yourselves. We got a whole lot of phonies running around. We got a whole whole lot of false professors running around. We got a whole lot of churchgoers running around. But how many disciples do we have? How many are studying the Word of God? How many are applying it to their life? So I understand why Jesus would pose this question. His disciples were on what we call the inner circle. They were with him day by day. They had witnessed, amen, the miracles that Jesus had performed. If you had been there, when you look around right now, how many miracles in your life can you say the Lord, amen, has wrought on you? How many times have God, amen, picked us up and turned us around? How many times have the Lord protected you and me from dangers seen as well as unseen? How many doors that have been shut and closed in our faces, and God has opened doors that no man can close? How many times have you been in want and in need, and God came to see about you? I don't know about you, but I'm so glad that I serve a living Savior. I wonder how often is it that when you've had difficulties with relationships, when you had, amen, outs with friends, and when your heart has been heavy, that God did not come by through that of Jesus and lift your heavy load. Oh, the songwriter said, heavy load, heavy load, I got rid of my heavy load. When you come into the presence of God, and when you can bow down and worship him, you can say, like Simon Peter says, thou art the Christ, the Son of the living God. What was Peter saying? Peter did not come to this answer by way of his own intelligence. Jesus recognized that, that God the Father had already, amen, given him the revelation. Here he says, thou art the Christ. Oh, I want to stop right there, because when he says, thou art the Christ, Peter was saying, I know who you are through the Spirit of God. Thou art the Messiah. Thou art the anointed one. You are the I am. And I come to bear record that Jesus looks at Peter and says unto Peter, amen, blessed art thou, amen, Simon Bar-Jonah, amen, for flesh and blood had not revealed this unto you. Brothers and sisters, what are you saying? Reverend Rector, I want you to know that your relationship with Christ, amen, and your knowledge of who he is did not come just by your intellect. It came because God brought revelation into your life as to who the Son of Man really is. If it had not been for the Lord on our side, just tell me, where would we be? Simon, the son of Bar-Jonah. Amen. Bar-Jonah meaning the dove. I come to bear record, he was the son of Bar-Jonah, who was known as the dove. And he said, flesh and blood did not reveal it unto thee. Brothers and sisters, there are some things in this world that only the revelation of God can show those who are of the Lord. This book is written to those who are believers. This word is coming to someone today, asking the question, do you know who he is? Oh, I want you to understand, you can't shout amen without knowing who he is. You can't have joy, amen, without knowing who he is. You don't have to fake it when you know who he is. So I stopped by just to let somebody know you may be down and you may be troubled, but we serve a God who is able to supply all of our needs according to his riches in glory. Do I know who he is? Oh, I know that he is the Messiah. I know that he is our advocate, our propitiation. I know who he is. He is our bridge over troubled waters. He is our battle axe in the time of battle. So I stop by to let you know that when Jesus asked this question, he was preparing you and I for the battle to come. We're living in a world that don't want to lift up the name of God. We're living in a world full of pleasure seekers. But I want to thank God, amen, for what he has done, amen, in the lives of the Pilgrimites. I want to thank God for what he has done in the lives of believers all over this world. So I stop by just to let you know, I know who he is. Every time we stand up to proclaim the word of God, I know who he is. I know that the teachings through the airways for the last 34 weeks, amen, was not rector, but it was God. He, amen, was giving me the imagination and the intelligence to speak on his behalf. And I'm so glad that I can tell a dying world who he is. He says, Simon Bar-Jonah, nobody revealed it to you but the Father, my Father, which is in heaven. Which means you got to be born again. You got to be full of the Spirit of God so that you can recognize that God is working in your life on a daily basis. He's not a part-time God. He's an every minute God. He's an everyday God. And when you start to complain the next time, look around and see how well you are. There's someone who is worse off than you. But do you know that he is a provider? Do you know that he will bless you 100-fold, 30-fold, and 40-fold. Don't you know that when God, amen, allows some things to be done in our lives, it's only a test of our faith. But I go on as we look at spiritual discernment. It bothers me that so many Christians are following devilish things. It bothers me when they say that they are saved and they are children of God and they are following a demon or a devil. The principles of God told us that we should love one another and treat one another right. He didn't tell us to be prejudiced. He didn't tell us to continue to hate. But he says, be ye angry and sin not. You may not like what somebody does, but you gotta keep on praying for them. So I stopped by to let you know, Pilgrim, I thank God for the journey that he has allowed Pastor Rector to be on. 36 years and 16 of them are now in Pilgrim Baptist Church. I thank God for giving me the strength and the power to preach his word every Sunday. I don't know about you, but I know where he brought me from. I know that he has kept me from danger seen and unseen. I know that everybody don't like me and don't love me, but Jesus says if they hated me, they're going to hate you. Well, go ahead, haters, and hate me for standing on the promise of God. For God has told me, amen, that he would take care of his preacher. And he tells us now, he says, I say unto thee, thou art Peter, and upon this rock I'm going to build my church, and the gates of hell shall not prevail against it. There are many who don't like the church. There are many who don't like religion. There are many who won't lift up the name of Jesus. But I'm so glad that Jesus claimed the church. I'm so glad that he uses the first person positive. I'm so glad that he possesses the lordship over the church that he has erected. Peter, thou art the son, of Simon Bar-Jonah. The dove of peace shall rest upon your life. And he goes on to say, the gates of hell shall not prevail against it. Well, brothers and sisters, let's get away from the physical church and let's go now to the spiritual church. When we look around, somebody knows he is a light in a dark place. He is hope when hope seemed to be gone. I don't know about you, but I know who he is. He is my bread when we're hungry. He is a way maker when there seems to be no way. When the devil says it can't be done, God will say, press on and trust in me. I don't care what the doctors say. You got to look to Dr. Jesus for the remedy. This coronavirus is rising all over the world. But yet and still, God is still in control. He is our light and he is our door. He is the good shepherd and he will lead us in the green pastures. I don't know who I'm talking to, but when your friends and when your loved ones want to cut up, I look to the hills from which cometh your help. Your help will come from the Lord. He will make a way out of no way for you. He will straighten out your life. Can I get a witness? I don't know about you, but I cannot speak for you, but I know him as a way maker. I know him as my protector. When enemies rise up against me, my God said they would not prevail. When your enemies don't like you, the God that we serve will bless your life in their face. Lo, I prepare a table before you in the presence of your enemies. So I compel you now, just hold on. Don't worry about 45. 45 is getting ready to take a ride. Don't worry about what's going on in D.C. For God has the government upon his shoulders. So I come to bear record that he tells his disciples, I want you to understand that I'm giving the keys to the kingdom unto those who are going to lead. Even though he talks about Peter, he says, I'm giving you, amen, some things that you can distribute in this world. I'm giving you the keys of heaven. I'm giving you the power to bind up those things on earth, that they will be bound in heaven. Loose those things that have tied folk down and turn them back to the way of God, giving humanity the liberty and the joy, giving them the understanding, giving them the power in themselves. If we got faith as a grain of mustard seed, we can tell every mountain, be thou removed and cast into the sea. There are many out there who got mountains in their lives, but the Bible says a little bitty seed, a seed, amen, that will grow into a mighty tree. If you got that kind of faith, God said you can move your mountains. Whatever's troubling you, Jesus says, shake it off and know that the devil won't win in this battle. So he tells Peter, I want you to tell the boys, I have already told you what I need you to do. I know you know me for yourself. I know you've watched the miracles of God, but I need you now to preach the word with confidence and with power. I want you to tell them they don't have to stay the way that they are. They can be liberated. They can be regenerated. They can be converted back to the Lord, for he is my resurrection and my life. Ain't the Lord all right? He is the way of truth and life. So I stopped by to let somebody know, stop your worrying, stop your complaining, for we serve a mighty God. Ain't the Lord all right? I feel all right. Down through the years, God has been good to this old boy. Nobody thought I would amount to anything, but God told me, if you go, I'll go with you. And for the last 16 years at Pilgrim Baptist Church, he has allowed me to stand and preach his holy word. He has allowed me to tell a dying world who he is. He is the Messiah. He is my everything. He is the I am. He is my doctor. He is my lawyer. What is he to you? Is he a way maker? Is he a heart fixer? Is he a mind regulator? Ain't he all right? Ain't he all right? And the Lord made ways out of no way. He is the eternal one. He is, amen, the bread of life. He is the I am that I am. He is the Son of the living God. He is my proxy. He took my place. He is the one that loved me. He is the one that kept me. He is the one that empowered me. He is the one that strengthened me. I say, can you praise him with me? Can you praise him with me? Ain't he all right? He's all right. I know he's all right. So I stop here just to let you know, why do I know him? Because he's not dead. Yeah, they hung him high and they stretched him wide, but he's not dead. He suffered on the cross in my place, but he's not dead. They took him down and laid him in a grave, but he's not dead. He stayed there all night Friday. He stayed there all day Saturday, but early on Sunday morning, my Savior, my Redeemer, my proxy, the Immaculate Lamb of God, got up from the grave, having all power in his hand. Ain't he all right? Ain't he all right? Can you feel him? Can you feel him? You ought to wrap your arms around somebody and let them know everything gonna be all right. No matter what you're going through, praise him anyhow. No matter how you feel, praise him anyhow. Ain't he all right? Ain't he all right? Ain't he all right? Ain't he all right? He's all right. He's all right. Do you know who he is? That's a question I just want to ask somebody. When God brings us out from under this pandemic, will you still know who he is? And will you be able to give him the praise, give him the glory, give him the, would you be willing to serve him because he has ministered to you and me? Charge them to go tell nobody that he was the Christ, the Savior of the world. Why? Because Jesus wanted them to see the move of God and praise God for being God and being in their midst. Miracles are not accidents. Miracles are providential. They are the favor of God upon those who need him. Brothers and sisters, I beckon unto you, hold on to your faith. God is not dead. He is very much alive. Jesus is still moving on the hearts of men and of women. And if there's someone that may be listening to this message and you don't know the Lord for yourself, I admonish you to make a change. All you got to do is believe in your heart that Jesus is the Son of God. Recognize your faults and your shortcomings, your sins, and ask the Lord into your life. Brothers and sisters, if that's you and you have realized who he is and you want to be saved, you want to be regenerated, you even want to be restored, then just repeat after me tonight. Father, I believe that Jesus is your Son because of the miraculous things that you've done in my life. I ask you in now. Come in and take control. I can't do it myself. And I realize I need you. Forgive me, because I do believe that he died, he was buried, but he rose again, not having some power, but having all power in his hand. In Jesus' name, amen. If you repeated these words, the Bible declares that you are now a child of the King. And the Spirit of God is now dwelling in your life. So brothers and sisters, I admonish you to study your Bible. Listen to the Word of God. Listen to Bible study. And tell the devil he can't stop this. Because when Jesus comes in, he has to go out. But he don't go out easily. So I tell you now, you may have to shift some things. You may have to stop running with some folk. You may have to get to yourself sometime. But God is able to lift you above all of your circumstances. So brothers and sisters, we thank God for you. We thank you for tuning in this morning. And we pray that you would have a God-blessed day. Let us go to the Lord in prayer. Father in heaven, we stretch our hands to thee, no other help we know. If thou wilt withdraw thyself from us, Lord, where shall we go? I humbly come before you at the mercy seat now, asking, O God, that you would just forgive us all of our sins and our trespasses. I ask that you would just cover each and every one who will hear this message. I hope that the words may find a lodging place in their hearts. So I ask you now that you would bless those who are sick, bless those who are recovering, bless those who have gone through a time of bereavement, bless all of the frontline workers, and bless those who are striving to do the right thing. Father, don't cut anybody down in their sins, but I pray that you will allow them to come to the knowledge of who you are through your Son, Jesus the Christ. This is your servant's prayer in the name of he who died that we might live, in the name of Jesus the Christ. Now, may the grace of God and the sweet communion of his Spirit continue to rest, rule, and abide with us now and forevermore. Let every heart watching this morning say amen, amen, and amen. And remember, Pastor Rector loves you, and there's nothing you can do about it. Have a very blessed day.
Until we have gotten away from its true purpose. It has become such big business until we allow people to operate and function as long as they have something to bring to the table. People are now more concerned about recording and living in life of the rich and famous rather than knowing Jesus. But the true purpose of the church is soul business, not big business. I don't know about you, but I would rather have nothing and know Jesus than to have everything and not know him. You need to confess him today.
Confess him with your mouth. Believe him in your heart. Do you know Jesus? Jesus. You can know Jesus in your heart. Confess him with your mouth. Believe him in your heart. Do you know Jesus?